This is India 360, coming to you live from New Delhi and Mumbai.
Good evening, you're tuning in to India 360, the show that debates issues that concern urban India, with me Sita Nair in New Delhi and Yogita in Mumbai. On the show tonight, first up tonight on India 360, tragedies yet again. Six persons of a single family were killed in the Crawford Market area after yet another building collapse. Well, I'm afraid we seem to be experiencing some audio problem there in the link with Yogita. But yes, the story that we're talking about, our top focus here, tragedy striking Mumbai, six persons of a single family killed in the Crawford Market area of South Mumbai early this morning after yet another building collapsed. Kajal Iyer brings us the story. In fact, Ms. Pratima Manohar, architect, founder and editor-in-chief of the Urban Vision, is joining us on the show tonight. Really, this building collapse in South Mumbai raises some bigger questions, some larger issues that need to be looked at. Remember, it's not the first building collapse that we've heard of. We'll be trying to speak to Parmita in just a bit. There are thousands of buildings, as you've been saying, that are more than half a century old in South Mumbai. Residents are refusing to move out, though, for redevelopment. Is that where a part of the problem really lies? Minita Srivastava finds out. Welcome back. You're watching India 360. Now, Yogita Lumia standing by in Mumbai to take us through the big story we are following here, home or death trap after that building collapse there in South Mumbai. Yogita. And to talk to us about why building collapses are happening as so often in Mumbai, joining us tonight on India 360, Pratima Manohar. She's an architect. She's also the editor-in-chief of the Urban Vision. Pratima, thanks very much for speaking to CNN. In this specific case today, the residents are saying that there was a piling that was happening in the vicinity of the building. That was the problem. Do you think, as an architect, that was the issue?
I don't think it would be a large part of the problem. A number of, you know, today was just another building of a, you know, host of buildings that have been collapsing in the city of Mumbai. And as we all know, there have been really all
there. Where do you think is, what is the larger problem? What is the reason for these collapses?
They are dilapidated. The government itself, the government agencies, classifies about 20,000 buildings as completely unsafe and problem altogether.
But you know, like we saw, we played out a story as well of residents who were unwilling to move out despite the fact that they were told that, you know, this building is dangerous. Because they're saying alternative arrangements are not good enough, they're too far away. How do you think a city like ours, you know, how do you think we can go about this redevelopment process? Like, where does it start? Who has to start? Is it the government, the VMC, the people themselves? Where do we, how do we go about it?
The government already has a strategy in place to redevelop large parts of Mumbai, which includes this 20,000 buildings, which is to allow private participation to redevelop these buildings. They're offering private enterprise incentives. But the contention that most people have with that is that it will lead to haphazard growth of the city. I think the solution for that is that we create a master plan of sorts, allow leading designers of the world to create some kind of a plan to for the city of the island city of Mumbai, and you know, then you are, we could allow private participation after that
process.
But we cannot clearly freeze the city in time. That is clearly causing a lot of these problems.
So you would be pro redevelopment. Okay, all right. Thanks very much, Pratima, for those details, for those inputs as an architect. That's it from me here in Mumbai. It's back to Delhi now.
Certainly some food for thought there. Now to our special series following Sensex and the Aam Aadmi.